Welcome to Synopsis Pictures. And today we will be talking about an episode of a Filipino drama show called Maalaala Mo Kaya. Would you remember in English? Please turn closed captions on for the best viewing experience. Our story starts with a stern senior woman named Clara. She caught her housemaid stealing a canned food in the pantry, who she immediately threw out. But a young woman named Dheng came to replace her. Clara gave her a briefing of the overview of her tasks ahead, and she happily accepts. The very next day, when she starts cleaning the mansion, Clara finds her to be over-responsive, annoying her with smart mouthing. And so she gets thrown out of the house, just like the maid before her. As Dheng was outside the employer's gate, she noticed her replacement and deviously plans a way to drive her out of the mansion. She sneaks in and hurls something at the new maid when she's not looking, alerting her that the house is haunted. Adding gasoline to the fire, Dheng abruptly turned the lights off, terrifying her to quit her job. On Clara's way out of the house with her Mercedes-Benz, Dheng reintroduces herself and offers to return if her permission is granted. Luckily for her, the madam was not in a terrible mood. One night when she was working in the kitchen, Clara handed her laundry. The husband suddenly arrived, who happened to divorce her several years ago, and she seemed excited to meet him. But the husband didn't take long and didn't even stay for dinner. The next night, as Clara brought her ballroom instructor to the house to get some exercise, her daughter Nancy makes an appearance, who seemed resentful to her mother and quite disrespectful for reasons not stated. She just showed for the sake of her mother's birthday, then storms out. One night, when Clara brought visitors over, who seemed to be of the same financial status as her, were very sarcastic with their words, telling Clara about how boring she has become. But Dheng defended her with her clever smart mouthing, leaving the other women speechless. When Nancy returned to visit her mother, still being volatile with her words, Dheng defends her employer with great passion that Clara's daughter was left in tears, and for the first time in a long while, she feels sympathy for Clara. One afternoon, Dheng's aunt came over to tell her and her employer that Dheng's mother has had a heart attack and is in need of some serious cash. But when Clara asked for a medical certificate from the doctor of her condition, the aunt could not provide. She could not even provide the name of the doctor who looked into Dheng's mother. The employer accused her of falsifying and sent her out of the mansion. After a few days, the aunt returns to the mansion bringing cops with her, accusing Clara of not paying Dheng her monthly wage. The aunt also informs Dheng that his mother has died of a heart attack because she didn't send cash home to buy for her mother's medication. Clara got arrested and is to be incarcerated. But on the bus ride home, as Dheng and her aunt was casually talking, the truth slipped from her lips that she was only fabricating her mother's death to extort her employer. She immediately got off the bus and went to the cops to absolve Clara of everything, telling them that she's innocent, and the aunt made up the whole thing to extract money from her. Nancy, Clara's daughter, came to the police station to bail her mother out. She apparently has a change of heart towards her. She had an epiphany that she only has one mother to love and to adore, thanks to the passionate words of Dheng that made her come to a self-realization. Clara gave Dheng a hug, like a mother to her daughter, before she takes another bus home. Back at home, she sees her mother alive and well. Dheng seems a little forlorn, knowing she left Clara in her lonely mansion. She apparently has grown attached to the old woman and feels sorry for her. Dheng receives a letter from Clara, telling her to return to the mansion and she can bring along her family to live with them, figuring that the mansion has plenty of lonely rooms with no one to occupy them. As she returned to Clara's mansion, the old woman is flabbergasted to see her again, telling her that the mansion is nothing but an empty shell without her. Clara welcomes Dheng's whole family to her mansion. She tells the children not to call her Lola, which means grandma in Filipino, but rather call her mother instead. Please subscribe to the channel, click the bell icon, or leave a like and a comment. It will help the channel out. Thank you for watching the Synopsis Pictures.